in our office, in our city, our office, in those people, we don't know who we're going to touch. You don't know who you're going to touch. You might be walking somewhere, you know, and God will bring that individual. They might have a situation in there, have their families going on, or there's something. God will use you. And you said, who am I? Oh, you're a child of God. You're a new creation. Amen? And God will use you to speak life into that person's life. Amen? Amen. That's why I said to him, my life is, I can't touch everybody, but I'm sure to touch everybody that I come in contact with. You know, and show them the love of Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Oh, wow. The life of Christ is what? Within us. We are what? A new creation. In who? In Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on now. Hallelujah. That's a hallelujah time. Hallelujah. And with this powerful revelation, we as believers will be what? Walking in the freedom and authority. Hallelujah. Of the word. Amen. In the authority and the boldness and the power and the victory in your life. Amen.
Amen.
The power and the victory in our lives as what? As ministers. Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to get you with this one now. Ministers. You know that you're called to be a minister, not just me. And, you know, that's the Great Commission. God said, what in the Great Commission? To love one another, to care for one another. How do they see Jesus? Through you, through me. All of us. How do they see Jesus? Wow, we're new creation. What? God is what? Within us. Amen? So that shows who we are. You know, we're no slow Joe anymore, right? We're children of God. You know, we're a royal priesthood, a chosen generation by God. Amen. And when you identify with that and know who you are and that spirit that's within you, I don't care what you face, you'll be able to stand. The Bible says when all things fall around you, all you need to do is just stand. And then when you don't even know what to say, at that time, what happens? The Holy Spirit that's within you arises and speaks for you. Isn't that cool? He arises and speaks for you. So when you don't even know what to say, maybe something you said, man, I went to the church. Pastor Benny said this, and he said, 2 Corinthians, God is within us, or whatever. It just comes right back into memory. That's what I mean, that the Holy Spirit arises, and then a verse comes right into your mind, and you tell that person, because now you recognize that the boldness, that spirit that's within you, the boldness arises. And now that you arise, you're able to speak life into that individual. Amen? Because you don't know. You don't know. You know there was a young lady. I'm going. And I tried to be friendly to her. I picked her up at 7 o'clock. My first pickup at the mall. The second pickup was at Walmart. You probably seen the young girl. I didn't tell you. She sat in the back, black hair. Remember she got off on CVS and she died. She died last week. 26 years old. 26 years old. The gentleman told me, you know the girl? I said, no, I'm 26 years old. She had a baby and she was trying to work, trying to make it. You know, things are hard for everybody, you know. Trying to make it, you know, maybe the husband left her. I don't know, you know, the circumstance. I'm just, you know, kind of. But, you know, she's 26 years old. She said, get on the bus. I used to pick her up. And I said, how do you do? I think her name was Michelle. I'm not sure who Michelle, because I meet people all the time. And, you know, I was telling her, man, it's good to see. I always try to put, you know, a happy face to people and say, you know, how you doing? Or I'll start joking or something. You know, not really getting religion on, because I know, you know, people could be touching. I'm in my job, but I'm being straight. But I make sure that I let you know, that you feel comfortable with me. And she could testify to that because she rides the bus with me. And I try to make myself comfortable. Your grandmother, how did I meet your grandmother? In the bus. Hallelujah. So I try to make people feel comfortable because I know who I am in the bone. How I met Mama Lola? In the bus. How did I meet her? She said, I know you. You're the bus driver. In the bus. I love my job. Because why? Not because of the money. God, that's for sure. But because of the people. And God said, be the light wherever you're at, because you don't know. But when I saw her at first, she wouldn't even say hello to me. She came in the bus. But I said, you know what, I'm going to keep trying every morning. How you doing? Good to see you. Have a great day. And, you know, after a while, she was smiling. Then she told me my name. I said, oh, that's your name up there? Because I put on the bus, Ben. Well, that's your name, Ben? Yes, that's my name. And then, you know, I was happy that I could make her, even for that little moment, smile. Because you never know. You never know. You know, I prayed that she had a relationship with God, I'll tell you that. And I prayed when I found out. I said, oh man, it hurt me. Because, you know, you meet someone so young, you see them trying to do the right thing, and then this happens, you know. And her child, you know, I don't know, a little girl, but to leave a child, you know, 26 years old. I don't know why I'm going, but this is leading to this message. That it is important to know who you are and to have a relationship with God, because we don't know that. The Bible says you don't know the day, the time, and when our ending is. You could die young, you could die old. You know, nobody knows. But if you know who you are in Christ and you know that bonus in the Holy Spirit, you know where you're going. This is just temporary. We all going to die physically. You know, but the Bible says we have eternal life. So it's important to know who you are. Amen. That's why God changed my whole message. And it's for you guys. I don't know why, but I always pray and I let the Holy Spirit lead me. Because sometimes I want to do this, and God says, no, do this. And I say, okay, Lord, your will be done, not mine. Amen?
Amen.
But just to show this young girl. Anyway, but what I said, he gives us a boldness, a power, and victory in our lives and in our ministry. Our ministry is that you will know who you're going to be. And that's how you minister to them. Because you can say a good word or just be there. I see the way you are with your friend. Oh, I forgot her name. How they share and they spend time. She's so happy when she sees you. You see? That's how I want people to think of it. Don't you want people to think? You want people to think, oh, here she come again. Oh, here come Danny. Oh, Lord, he talks too much. I'm just using an example. Because you're the only other male. I said, well, it's four. No, hallelujah. Well, I had a number of women here. But you know, and JJ, you know, you never know. They say, here come JJ. No. When you come in the room, because the Spirit of the Lord is within you, the boldness, hallelujah. You come here and say, oh man, that's JJ. Hallelujah. You know, I love JJ, man. I love being around because he's always what? Encouraged. He makes me feel good. You know, he always got a good word. And what you do, for that little moment, I'm gonna be thinking, man, I don't even got money for gasoline in my car. And all of a sudden, here comes JJ walking out. That's God. Here comes JJ using JJ to walk down the street. And all of a sudden, I forget about the issue with the gas, and I'm just happy to see JJ because he gave me a smile. And then on top, God is so good. JJ said, I don't know why, but I don't know, man. God told me to give me $5 or $10, whatever it is. And what do? You start praising God. Because what? God can use anybody in anything. And the Bible said that we all call to minister. You see, it's not just me. You know, it's you too. All of us are called to do something kingdom with God. And it's how we live our lives and how we portray the love of Christ and just being nice to each other. That's what God wanted. It ain't no big revelation. I mean, love one another. Share. You know, help each other, you know, in spirit and in truth. You know what I'm saying? And once you do that, not only did they feel the joy around you, but they see Christ in you. And not only that, it benefits you because you feel that joy. Doesn't it feel good when you did something for somebody?
Yes.
You really, you know, we don't want the credit, but deep down on the side. Let's be honest, yeah, I did that. Yeah, I'm glad. I looked up. Didn't have money. I was able to, you know, it gives you a joy that's and that's the way God, and you know what God is looking down on us? And he's smiling. He said, that's my daughter, that's my son. Amen.
Amen.
And then when you say, you know, you need something, and you're thinking about, man, I need a car or something, God already knows. You don't have to ask him. Because you've been faithful in the little, what the Bible says, he'll give you much. And what God is saying, don't worry, I got you covered. And when you suspect that somebody come, hey, here's a car, you're like, what? It's happened to me. What? How did it come? What? I'm still waiting. God showed me someone's going to give me a check with a lot of zeros. I'm telling you. I believe it, and I trust in God. Someone's going to give me money, not for me personally, but I'm going to use that money for the kingdom of God. You know, because everything I have is his anyway. I can't wait. I'll be honest with you. I cannot wait to the day that I don't have to work for anybody. Just do this full time. Because I know if I do this full time, I'll be able to touch a lot of people. I'll get in my car. I'm the kind of pastor, I'll go to your house. That's the type of person I am. I'll go to your house and I'll say, how you doing? And the Holy Spirit comes within me, and he does. I want to tell you, that's one of the gifts of there's nine gifts to the Holy Spirit. He gives you discerning spirit. And I'm bold enough that if we have that relationship, I'm opening up your refrigerator and make sure everything's in there. And if you don't, I don't be ashamed. Say, no, we're going shopping. You know, that's the way we're supposed to be. That's how we show the love of Christ. And that's the kind of person that I am. And I want to be, because I want to do what God told me to do. Amen. You know? Because it's not about, I ain't taking nothing. Whoever thinks that they have all this money, all this property, that when they die, they ain't taking nothing with them. That's the truth. They ain't taking nothing. But when is it going to be said? When they got you laid out in the coffin. Are you going to have people there saying, wow, I'm glad he's gone. He still owed me money, man. He didn't even pay my $20 he owed me. You know what I'm saying? Or what they're going to be saying, man, I'm going to miss that person. Man, I remember the day, and that's so important, is your legacy, what God's done. And that's how God looks at you. You know, that's what I'm saying, you got to know who you are. When he says, I remember the day, man, that Pastor Ben came to my house, man, and I didn't even tell nobody. You know, and how God used that man to come into my house to speak life, you know, to help me in whatever situation it was. You know what I'm saying? Oh, man, I'm stuck on the road, and all of a sudden I see a car coming down the road, and guess who it is? With gospel music on, and he's coming down the road and say, hey, what's the problem? Hey, you need to move? Hey, let's move. You know, those little things that will come into remembrance, you see? And that's what we got to do with God. We got to remember all his goodness and everything he's done for us. And when we do that, those are the blessings. And those are the riches that the Bible says that we will have. The riches of what? The Holy Spirit that's within us. Amen? If you want to go next door, we got a room. They got coloring books. Okay.
We won't go.
Yeah, all right. He wants to stay with mama. All right, that's cool. But you know what? That's who we got to know who we are. Amen? Are you guys excited so far? My message is coming to you? Because I tell you, I want to speak life into you. I don't want to let you go until God blesses you. Amen? With his word. Amen? But again, I'll just get real quick into it. But we will find ourselves a boldness within us. Hallelujah. A boldness within us. Amen? Okay, now, let's go to B. Let's go right to B. And I want everybody to say it, because I want you to speak it. As we speak it into the atmosphere, that's why it's so important to worship. When we worship God, the Holy Spirit comes out, and God wants you to say it. Because the mouth can what? Can bring someone to life, and it also can kill someone too. Amen? So it's important what we say. What's number one? And I want it nice and loud so they can hear it on the video. What's number one?
I know who I am in
who?
Jesus Christ.
Amen. Number two?
I am what you say that I am.
I am what? What? I didn't hear y'all. Come on. I'll meet everybody.
I am what you say that I am.
Okay. Number three?
I can do what you say that I am.
This is his work. Number four?
I can have what you say that I can.
Amen. See? What the Bible says in that part, that he gives you the desires of your heart. Amen. Sometimes we put petitions. Lord, I need this. Lord, I need that. Lord, I say, man, I'm tired of it. What you need? You know what I'm saying? Let's be honest. I'm tired of you telling me what I already know what you need. You need to stop telling me what you need. God is awesome God, but that's not saying to stop telling me what you need. Do what I tell you. If you do what I said, if you follow my law and you follow my word, I am with thee. And anything that you ask of me, if you say to that mountain, move, it'll move. The word says, I'm not saying it. The word is saying this. Amen? But he's saying, do the basics. I always do it, and I'm going to do it again, because sometimes I like to be